Hey guys, don't forget to hit the bell icon next to the subscribe button so that you can be notified every time I come up with a new video.
Hi guys, what's up? Thank you so much for coming back. I'm Arpita and I welcome you back yet again to the Crazy Wisdom. Alright, so I'm back with another compatibility video and today we'll be talking about the compatibility of the witty and the serious Virgos with the rest of the zodiac belt. So what are we waiting for? Put on your thinking caps and your wisdom boots. Let's get on and shoot. Now when an Aries comes into the picture, the fun part gets affected because you know a Virgo is the last person to indulge themselves in anything not thought about or in anything reckless. Whereas an Aries is the complete opposite of this, you know, they want to be the part of everything exciting and everything out of the ordinary. So you know there's an imbalance here. Love again gets affected here because a Virgo is a very calm and mature form of Mercury. You know, they want a very stable and practical and a very steady relationship in their life. Whereas an Aries is an eternal kid, as we all know, and they don't even know the M of maturity. Work again is a problematic area because a Virgo's vigorous analysis and thoughts clashes with an Aries' go-getter attitude and let's not think about this much nature, and therefore there are a lot of fights, and in the end this relationship does not sustain. Now when a Taurus comes into the picture, the fun part goes up because you know they understand really well a Virgo's need to be slow and steady and introspective whenever they are in the middle of a crowd or whenever they are in the middle of a lot of people, and therefore they do not push a Virgo beyond they can handle at one point of time and before they want to open up. So you know they are pretty balanced here. Love can be a little stressful here because you know a Virgo can be a little too slow in expressing their feelings, and a Taurus on the other hand cannot wait for this long without a proper assurance or without a sense of commitment from the other end, and therefore there is a little imbalance here. Work again works brilliantly here because this combination is a nice mixture of practicality and creativity, of ideas and money-making ability, and therefore overall also this combination, you know, this pair works really well. Now when a Gemini comes into the picture, fun can be really problematic because you know the Gemini's habit of continuously pushing a Virgo beyond their limit of tolerance, you know, can actually irritate and frustrate them so much that a sort of Mercury stubbornness creeps in the relationship, and they become so stubborn that they flat out refuse to enjoy for even 5 minutes with the Gemini, and this sort of results in fights and a lot of ego clash. Love again suffers here because you know a Virgo has very very different expectations from their partner. They want them to stand with them like a strong wall of defense and a strong wall of guard through all the ups and downs and through all the small little issues of life. Whereas a Gemini is an absolutely free-spirited kid and they do not want so many expectations from them. Work on the other hand here can work a little better because you know at the end of the day, both are the same brains involved in a project. One is behind the kid and the other is behind an adult. So you know their cumulative analysis can go just another level. And the Gemini go-getter attitude and the Gemini energy can actually take the entire project to a successful completion. But you know, apart from this one aspect, overall this relationship fails to work and it is not such a good one. Now, a Virgo and a Cancerian. Now, the aspect of fun can work really well here because, you know, both are sort of introverts and both take their fair share of time in, you know, in coming out of their shells. And although this can be a little boring and a little monotonous a lot of times, but, you know, at the end of the day, these two people find peace together because they both sort of understand each other's need to, you know, get proper time and space before they indulge into anything. Now, love can be a little problematic because, you know, a Cancerian is 200% about emotions and a Virgo is, you know, practicality at its highest level, and when these two people go out of sync, these two can stretch themselves at opposite ends and they have a lot of difficulty in finding each other then. Work again works brilliantly here because Virgo is mind and analysis and a Cancerian is execution and money making, and therefore when these two balanced brain powers get together to work, they can actually create wonders together. So you know overall this relationship works well. Now when a Leo comes into the picture, fun and love sort of both get affected here because you know a Leo on one hand is a very extravagant person, you know, they are huge displayers, whereas a Virgo is the complete opposite. You know, these are the people who like to take things slow and steady, and they want to keep their fun life and their relationships very well under wraps. So you know, a major clash of personalities is seen here. Work again goes downhill here because a Leo is all about creativity and huge risk-taking abilities, whereas a Virgo is a very very safe player at their mindful actions and their careful analysis and planning and execution, and therefore again they clash a lot and overall this relationship fails to work. Now, when another Virgo comes into the picture, fun and love both can get affected, you know, because it can turn very, very boring and monotonous because of both of their laid-back attitude and sort of you-first nature. And because of this, the entire relationship sort of starts lacking a lot of initiative and there is no action or there's no love seen at a lot of times. Work here can work a little better because, you know, both of these people involved are super brains and when they get down to work, their analysis can be super amazing and brilliant. But again, too much thinking and too less action sort of makes the entire task lack a lot of creativity and it makes it boring and monotonous and it sort of lags behind from all others. And therefore, overall, this relationship sort of lacks that sparkle. Now, when another Libra comes into the picture, fun can suffer because, you know, a Libra is all about initiative and center stage, whereas a Virgo is very, very reserved and shy. And therefore, too much drama can happen if a Libra tries to open up a Virgo against their wishes. Love, again, can suffer big time here because, first of all, these people take an eternity to, you know, come into a relationship because both of them are commitment phobic and both of them do a lot of analysis in love matters and relationship matters. And even if they come into one, then, you know, a Libra's flirtatious nature and their airy, carefree attitude is a strict deal breaker for a Virgo and therefore it suffers a lot. Now, work here can work a little better because, you know, both Libra and Virgo have this habit of thinking and analyzing a lot before taking action. And, you know, they can have, they can produce amazing results together. But, you know, just in case a Libra gets very easy breezy and laid back in front of the perfectionist Virgos, then this aspect can also fail badly. And therefore, taking this into consideration, overall, this relationship fails to work. Now, when a Scorpio comes into the picture, the aspect of fun works really well because both of these people are sort of reserved and into their own self sort of people and a Virgo wants to enjoy only with the people that they want to enjoy with and they do not want to make a scene out of their togetherness or, you know, out of their moments of fun and enjoyment. And who understands this better than the deep-rooted Scorpio? So, you know, this works well. Love, again, works brilliantly because both of these people are careful planners and they take steps very, very carefully when it comes to choosing a life partner. They want a relationship and a sort of a passionate bond that lasts longer than life. And both of these people are one partner person if they find their perfect soulmate. So, you know, this works magically well. Now, work can be a little tricky here if both of them do not have enough trust on each other. But if they develop that thing in them, then, you know, a Virgo's super brain sort of an analysis and a Scorpio's careful planning and planned tricks and plotted strategies can actually create wonders in the professional market and it can actually leave everyone behind. So, you know, overall, this is a very nice combination. Now, when we talk about a Virgo and a Sagittarius coming together, the aspect of fun can suffer a lot, you know, because a Virgo is sort of usually focused on, you know, the day-to-day tasks and daily routine and the daily challenges that they face in their work life and in their personal life. Whereas a Scorpio, on the other hand, is completely spontaneous and a chirpy human being who wants to experience everything new every single day. You know, they do not want that daily monotonous routine. So it does not work. It has a major clash here. Love, again, can be a bit problematic because here sobriety meets that carefree attitude and they can clash big time. You know, a Sagittarius wants to express their romance and express their love in a whirlwind way at every step of their relationship, whereas a Virgo wants a more serious and a more mature and a more responsible partner. And therefore, again, a major clash occurs here. Work, again, can work a little better, but only to some extent here because, you know, what attracts a Virgo is a Sagittarius' immense knowledge. But, you know, after a point of time, they can again seem to be very, very irresponsible, tactless and haphazard to the very, very perfection-seeking Virgo. And therefore, two opposite ends of a cord come together and amalgamation is very tough. And therefore, this relationship does not work that well. Now, when we talk about Virgo and Capricorn, fun here works amazingly well because both of them are the sort of people who do not want a fancy location to sit, who do not want 1,000 people to notice them while they're having fun, or they do not want 300 different ideas to party every single day. You know, they can just sit together with each other in a comfortable setting, talk to each other, confide in each other about what happened the entire day at office or at home, and they can just feel full with that feeling itself. So, you know, it is an amazing combination. Love, again, works brilliantly because here a Virgo again gets that feeling of fullness when they are with a Capricorn. Because, you know, there's nothing fake here. There's nothing show off here, you know. Capricorn offers a very, very real, a very practical and a very closer to life sort of a relationship. They make real promises with their partners and fulfill them, you know. Work again works wonders because, you know, a Mercury's brain power and a Saturn's dedication and commitment to work sort of creates immense success. And you know, who can stop research and hard work when it comes together? The only thing that they need to be careful about is to trust each other 200%, to take each and everything to their to its 100% level, and overall this relationship works really well. Now when an Aquarius comes in the picture, the level of fun goes really down because, you know, a Virgo is an extremely practical and real person and they want complete assurance and a complete picture of the next day in their mind before they can waste their present night away. Whereas on the other hand, an Aquarius, when starts to have fun, they can, you know, they do not stop until they drop, and you know, they can enjoy in the most weird and outworldly ways possible and no one can stop them before they want to stop. They just become extremely carefree. And this does not work because there's a major clash seen here. Love again suffers here because, you know, an Aquarius's nature of being absolutely cut from the emotional circle is like a blow to a Virgo. And because, you know, no matter how much they shy away from commitment at first place, once they do, a Virgo wants complete assurance and a complete real feeling of being in a relationship once they are into one, which an Aquarius finds very difficult to offer, you know. As we know, they are extremely detached and thus this again falters. Work not at all, because a Virgo's practical and completely ground level real mind just cannot understand what an Aquarius is trying to make them see from the unknown and from the unseen. And therefore, you know, a major, major clash occurs here, and overall this relationship does not work at all. And finally, when it comes to Virgo and Pisces, when it comes down to fun and love, both of them are sort of the same, you know. Both of them want to enjoy with only their partners. Both of them want to sit together rather than show off their, you know, togetherness to the entire world. But one thing that they can clash on is when a Piscean need to feel their partner and their need to have their partner around them, especially during their low phases, arises, you know. Because a Virgo just cannot offer that much emotional support. They are too busy in their day-to-day lives and in handling their day-to-day challenges and obstructions and tasks, you know, that they do not have any free time for an emotional conversation or for an emotional exchange. And therefore, they fail to work at that level. Now, in the aspect of work, you know, a Virgo's fine analysis and money-making mind can actually extract amazing ideas from a Piscean's pool of creativity, and they both can rise like anything. But you know, again, when it gets too much, when a Piscean's ideas refuse to touch reality at any level, then you know, it can actually cause a clash and it can actually irritate a Virgo. And so, you know, overall a Virgo and a Piscean's relationship goes like a sine wave of ups and downs, and if they conquer their downs, then you know, they can rise during their ups and this relationship can work. Alright guys, so with this I put a wrap on today's video. I hope you liked it, and if you did, don't forget to leave a cute thumbs up right underneath it, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel in order to remain updated with all the latest news and gossip on Zodiacs, astrology and motivation. With this, I'll be meeting you again too soon, but don't forget to be crazy and wise until we meet for the next time. I'll see you guys sooner. Bye bye.